Okay, welcome to part three of Learn to Code here. And we're going to have a little look at variables in this video. But just before we do, in the last video, I used something called comments. And that's these things here where we've got a hash symbol and we can type anything after it and the computer will ignore what we type in. And this is quite helpful if you want to write little notes to yourself in the code, or if you're working with another programmer, you can write notes to them. And often it's used to kind of help explain sections of code. And it's a really good habit to get into using comments. So all you need is the hash, and then anything you write after should go red. You'll notice if you go to the next line, it won't carry on. So if you want another line, you just have to put another hash in, and then you can write whatever you like after it. So have a go at comments as you're going through this, just to explain what's going on. So, variables. A variable in a program is a way of saving a piece of information that we can use at any point. And what I've done here is I've done what's called declare a variable. So I've given the variable a name. Okay, and the name can be anything you like. The only thing it can't be are command words. So, for example, words like print. And you'll know that's a command word because it goes that sort of purpley color. So, as long as it doesn't do that, you should be fine with a name. The name should be descriptive of what the variable is. So, don't put in something random, like that as a variable name because that wouldn't make sense. Or that, okay. Put in something descriptive of what the variable is. So in this case, I've got a score and I've put the equal sign. And then I've just put in a string value of 45. I haven't used an integer because at this point, I don't want to do any calculations on it. I just want it to be a string value of 45. So what we can do now is we can use this variable at any point in the program. And essentially, the variable in this case is 45. So what a variable does is it saves a bit of information in your program. So it saved the string 45 anytime I use the name score. Okay. So for example, we could have something like this. Okay. So print score. You'll notice it's not in speech marks, it's not a string, it's a variable, so I haven't had to use speech marks. So when we run this program, we should just see whatever the variable value is, so 45. Okay, good. So we could then take this a bit further. We could maybe add a string in as well, just to make it look a bit better. So the score is close string, comma, score. Okay, so this should give us a sentence which says the score is 45. So let's check that works. It does, good. And you can see here, within this print statement, we've split things up with a comma. So we've got a string, we've got a variable, and they're split with a comma. So anytime you do things like that in a print statement, split things up with commas. Okay, the only time you don't need a comma is at the end. Doesn't really matter, but you don't really need one. Now, because we've got the variable declared as 45, what we can do is we can use it at any point in the program. It saved the word 45. Okay, so we could have, for example, another print statement using the same variable. Okay, and it will remember what score is, in this case 45, and it will use it at any time. So this is quite handy because if we ever wanted to change our score, we only need to change it once, and then it would change across the whole program. Okay, so this is the reason why we use variables. It makes our lives much easier. We don't have to now change things manually. We can just change it once and it will change through the whole program. So have a little go at variables. Maybe declare a couple of other variables. Can you get more than one variable in one print statement? Try it out and see how you get on.